Welcome to Community Matters, brought to you by Washington County Department of Health and Human Services. I'm your host, Andy Cartmill, and we're here each month with a variety of topics and guests with the goal of keeping you safe, healthy, and well-informed. Today, we're here at Fireside Home Solutions talking about one of my favorite wintertime activities, enjoying a nice warm fire. We're joined by Matt Davis, Senior Program Coordinator with Washington County's Environmental Health Program, and Tim Reed, Manager of Fireside Home Solutions.
So Matt and Tim, welcome, and thanks for having us. Matt, I'm curious, why does Washington County Department of Health and Human Services care about wood stoves or fireplaces?
That's a great question, Andy. So wood burning can be a really cost-effective way to heat your home. But unfortunately, the smoke from wood burning contains really tiny particles that can cause big health problems, especially for vulnerable groups like younger children or older adults or folks who may have a respiratory condition.
So when you say tiny, how tiny are we talking here?
Yeah, so imagine how thick your hair is and then divide that into 50 parts. And that's how tiny the particles are. And it's their small size that make them so dangerous. So when we breathe them in, they can go really deep into the lungs, aggravating conditions like asthma or emphysema.
Wow, especially if we're doing that day after day after day in the winter, right?
Right.
Wow. And this, how big of a problem are these particles in Washington County?
Yeah, so most of the time in Washington County, we have really low levels of these particles.
That's good.
The problem comes when we get cold air inversions, and that's when the cold air and the smoke in the air gets stuck near the Earth's surface for hours or sometimes days. And the smoke particles start to build up over time. And a couple times each year, we see the levels of those particles get so high that we're exceeding federal health standards.
And this gets built up from hundreds and thousands of fireplaces and wood stoves.
Exactly.
And things like that. Wow. And then, so is this really a weather issue we're talking about then?
Yeah, so it's partly a weather problem. I mean, we can't control when cold air inversions are going to happen or how long they're going to stay. But luckily, there are things we can do to reduce the smoke or those particles that we produce by burning wood. I think Tim's going to have some suggestions.
Okay, well, Tim, that's a good segue there. I imagine people are burning wood in all sorts of stoves and fireplaces, right?
That's right. You see people burning everything from traditional freestanding wood stoves to fireplace inserts, which is basically a wood stove with no legs that gets inserted into an existing open fireplace. We also see pellet stoves and pellet inserts, which burn basically compressed sawdust into an efficient heat source as well.
So what about older homes?
Yeah, that's a good question too. There's a ton of older homes out there that have open masonry brick fireplaces that people love burning in for Christmas time. They like the snap, crackle, and pop of it. And some people actually try to heat their homes with these. Open fireplaces are really just decorative. Because the fireplace is open and a fire takes air to get going, you're actually pulling all the air out of your home that your furnace is heated up, you're sucking it out the chimney, and you get a little bit of heat inside the room, but your house is actually colder when you're all said and done. What we really recommend is putting in a fireplace insert, whether wood, whether gas, or whether pellet. As you do this, you seal off your chimney completely so you're not losing any energy, and you're taking that heat that would be going outside the chimney and you're bringing it into the room. So it still keeps the ambiance, the warmth, the beauty, the aesthetics of a wood fireplace, but it saves you tons and tons of time and energy.
Good advice. So are there certain stoves that create more particles like the ones Matt was talking about?
Yeah, absolutely. Back in the late 1980s, there was a committee that was started by the EPA and the DEQ to start to curtail wood smoke emissions, and Oregon was actually the first state to do that. So prior to about 1988, there was no regulations on how wood stoves were burned. Once EPA and DEQ came together, they came up with a safe rating for where stoves needed to go. It challenged the technology that was available at the time, and it made manufacturers rethink the way that wood stoves were made. And they came out on the other side with certified and efficient wood stoves that are great for heating the home and great for the environment as
well. Okay. What is a certified stove, and how could one tell if their stove is certified?
Yeah, that's a great question. Well, certified stoves is anything that has met the EPA and DEQ regulations. Any wood stove that is certified, usually on the back of the stove, has a manufacturer's plate that documents the make and model of the stove, the safe clearances to combustible materials, and also gives you a stamp at the bottom of it showing that it meets EPA criteria.
Okay, and that's pretty obvious when you look at that, what that means.
It should be. On most models, it's on the back of the stove. Sometimes on a fireplace insert, it's at the bottom in the front, but any certified stove should have that manufacturer's tag.
So I have an older stove. Can I get an older stove? up to certification?
Unfortunately, you can't.
Ah.
At the time those older stoves were made, the technology just was not there, and there is no way to retroactively put that into an older stove.
Okay. And so what are my options then?
Well, the options, number one, would be to replace an older inefficient stove or an open fireplace with a certified and efficient wood fireplace, wood stove, wood insert, or a pellet product that would do the same thing.
Okay.
If you can't afford to do that, there's still different things you can do to burn wood in a safe and environmentally conscientious way, even if you don't have a certified stove, if you're burning in just an open fireplace.
Tell us a little bit more about that.
Well, a couple things. The first thing is that in wood stoves, you want to burn hot fires. A smoldering fire is going to put off a lot of smoke. If you're burning hot fires inside, you're going to be burning the wood at a cleaner way that's going to be putting off less particulate into the atmosphere.
Hmm.
The second thing is moisture. We have a moisture meter that's right over here. In any wood stove, you want to make sure that you're burning seasoned firewood. And with a moisture meter like this, you can stick it into your stove and it's going to give you a percentage reading of what the moisture content of that wood is. If you're burning wood that has a higher moisture content than around 20%, your wood is going to just smolder and smolder and smolder, and you'll have huge issues with creosote and soot and particulate, and then the particles that Matt was talking about as well going into the atmosphere. So hot fires and dry firewood are the biggest keys to burning safely.
Okay. Now, just to clarify, you said stick it in your stove. You meant stick it into the wood, right?
That's right. I'm sorry. Yeah, stick
it in. We don't want to advocate people. Okay.
No, stick that into your firewood. And that moisture meter has metal prongs on the end of it. So you stick it into that firewood. It gives you a percentage reading right there. So you can tell if your wood is safe or not.
Perfect.
We recommend at Fireside that your wood is split and stacked under cover for a full year before you burn it.
Okay, that's great. What other tips do you have?
Well, I'd say the biggest thing outside of that is making sure that whatever you burn is dry seasoned cordwood. There's some people that are throwing trash, 2x4s, garbage inside of their fireplaces and stoves. That causes huge issues. These products are meant to burn dry cordwood. And that's going to save you energy, it's going to save you money, it's going to have a cleaner chimney, be much better for the environment.
Wow, excellent information, especially with the 2x4s. I never even thought of that. Matt, winter's approaching, right? So tell me about the red, yellow, and green alerts.
Yeah, so starting this winter, Washington County is going to be monitoring the air quality on a daily basis and issuing alerts when the air quality is especially bad. So you'll see that green day means the air quality is healthy. Yellow day means that the air quality is unhealthy for those sensitive groups like children and older adults. And we'll be asking folks if they don't need to burn to not burn that day. And then red days are those few instances that I mentioned when the air quality is really unhealthy. And on those days, fireplace and wood stove use won't be allowed, unless, of course, it's the only way you heat your home, or if you need to use wood for financial reasons.
Okay. All right. Well, that's good to know. And then how can people find out what the air quality status is? How do they find these alerts?
Sure, yeah. So we're really encouraging folks to sign up at publicalerts.org, and we'll be sending out just the red day alerts using public alerts. And you can also check on a daily basis at our website or by calling our wood burning and air quality hotline.
Okay, publicalerts.org. I'll do it.
Great.
All right. Hey, guys, thank you so very much for all the information that you provided. And I think this is awesome. I learned a ton just in the few minutes we've been together. And thank you for watching and helping to keep our community healthy. For more information about air quality and to sign up for alerts, visit our website. Until next time, this is Andy Cartmill for Community Matters.